Next in line is the iClass project, mentored by Mr. Ajay Babar, Mr. Arun Nair, and Mr. Ninad Chilap. This project is self-explanatory, so let's not waste any time and call the team.
Very good evening to all of you present here. I, Lavish Kothari, along with our classroom interaction team, will be presenting a brief demo of our iClass interaction app. And we'll also be giving you a short demo. We'll be giving a tab to Sir and all that. So first of all, I'd like to introduce all of you to our team members, Mohit, Adil, Ankit, Kaushik, and Prakhar. Okay. First of all, I'd like you to tell what is iClass. iClass is an interactive classroom live audio streaming system. I would like to imagine a scenario like we are having a big classroom and we are having enough strength in our classroom. And suppose from the first two rows a student stands and he asks the professor some questions like anything he asks the professor. So a student sitting at the back will not be able to hear what the student in the front is asking. And if professor starts answering that question, the student at the back will not be able to get to what question the professor is answering. He will not be able to get the question. So in the present scenario, what we do is we will be using some mics and all. Suppose we'll be having in this auditorium, like we'll be having 3, 4 or at max 5 mics and not more than that. With these mics, it will be solving our problem and we'll be solving our problem to a good extent. But I'd like to imagine a scenario like what if each one of you is having your own mic? Most of you will be thinking that okay, it is not possible, it is not feasible. We have developed such an app that it is possible using our iClass app. I'd also like to tell you that what will be happening, like if you will be having only 2 or 3 mics, suppose one mic is here and one mic is here, and a student sitting in the mid wants to say something or have any query and he wants to ask something to the professor, then what will happen, that mic should be transferred from there to there. In a case you will be appointing a special person and he will be transferring the mic, it will be wasting time, it will be creating disturbance. In the second scenario, it will be passed to student by student, and it will be going there. So it will also be creating a good disturbance in the class. So we don't want that thing. What our achievements were, we did all these things and we eradicated all these things that we are encountering, these disturbances and these wastage of time, by our classroom interaction app. Now I'd like to introduce what our app consists of. Our app consists of basically 3 modules. The first module is the client module. The client module means we will be having an Android app that will be distributed among all these students. The students will be acting as clients and they will be having a facility to ask text doubts along with audio doubts. On the second module, we have our server app. The server app will be given to the professor. Before starting a lecture, the professor will be starting the server side of the total app, and when the app will be started, the server will be in the listening mode, both for the text doubt along with the audio doubt. The students, those who are clients, can request a text doubt and can also request for a audio doubt, and at a specific interval of time, when the professor finds okay, now I have to answer a question, he will be granting permissions for the audio streaming, and the student can speak. Along with this, we have also developed an iClass forum. The forum is basically used for storing the text doubts. All the text doubts that we discuss in the class will be at the end of the session, will be automatically exported to the forum that we have developed. I'd like to invite Kaushik and Ankit for a live demo.
So good afternoon everyone, I'm Kaushik Bhagwatkar and I'll give a short introduction of what is our client. So the iClass client is an Android app which is specifically designed for the Akash app, but it can run on every Android device which has version 1.9 and above. So now this is the basic UI. This is the first screen that we get after opening the app. From this screen you can create a new account, delete the account, change password, and all the features that we'll see in the demo. Now after you are logged in, you will be establishing connection with the server. So for connecting, we need the IP address and session ID. Session ID will be generated at random by the server that we'll talk about just after some time. And the IP address, first the connection is successful, then the IP address is stored in the config file, so we don't have to enter it again and again. After the successful connection with the server, this screen will be presented, which is of text doubts. Text doubts you can send directly from here by putting the subject and your doubt. You can also view the history also from there, which doubts I have asked in this particular session. That red mic button is for the requesting audio doubt. As soon as we press the button, this screen is presented where the position of user in the current queue, waiting queue, is displayed. I invite Ankit to give demo about server.
Yeah, hello everyone. I'm myself Ankit Kumar. I'm going to give a short demo on server side of the application. The server app is OS independent, means it can run on any OS like Mac, Linux, or Windows. The Java should be installed on the machine on which the app is supposed to run. And the user interface is completely implemented on JavaSwing, which doesn't require any external Java library. So this is the first main screen of the app of the server side, which contains mainly of three parts: the audio panel, the text panel, and the search functionality. The audio panel contains all the audio text that has been sent by the student. Yeah, the text panel contains all the text out that has been sent by the student, which whose attributes are the image of the student, after that the username and the doubt subject and the whole doubt. After that there is a two button, tick and cross. If the professor thinks that yeah, it is a good doubt and he want to discuss in the class, then he will click on the tick button. So when the professor will click on the tick button, then a window will pop up with the image of the student who has sent the message and the Android, means that is the doubt subject, and the the whole doubt. So and he will be discussing. If the professor thinks no, this is not a relevant doubt of the lecture, so he can just click on the that cross button, and the entry will be removed from the panel. Same works with the audio panel. And the functionalities are same of the click button and the cross button. So we will having a quick demo on this app.
So this is the client first screen. Here you can log in. This is the create new account button. If you want to delete your present account, then you can just swipe to delete. You will be getting a prompt for password. When you click for logging into an account, you will also need a password to log in. Here is a feature for forgot password. When you click on it, you will prompted for roll number and date of birth. If you want to change your password, then fill in your roll number and date of birth that you put while registering, and you can change it. Now we'll create a new account. Here we can also take the photo, and if the lighting conditions are not good enough, then we can also choose the photo from gallery. Now once we are registered, we are here for the establishing connection. Now this is for the IP address. I told you that it is already stored in the config file once we are connected. And this is the session ID that will be generated by the server.
So now that is the part where we establish the connection between the client and the server. So when you start the server application, the first window that you get, the professor has to fill all these lecture details like professor name with the department, the subject and topic. Let's fill it. Yeah, this is the main screen that I shown in the demo, means the presentation part. That is the IP address of my system, and this is the session ID. The main use of the session ID is that it will be randomly generated on each lecture. So that a person is sitting at home or is in the same Wi-Fi system cannot send a doubt to me. So means for establishing the connection between the client and the server, you need both IP address and the session ID. So Kaushik, please enter both. Session ID is 4309. Yeah, that was displayed on the screen.
Now the connection is successful and we have got the screen where we can ask the text doubt also and audio doubt also.
Please display the screen on the.
So from here now we submit the text doubt.
Wait, yeah.
It will ask if you want to review your doubt or you want to just submit. If you press on OK, then the doubt will be sent.
Doubt has been sent.
We got the those doubts sent, and there it will be received.
I received a doubt text from username Prakhar. Yeah. doubt subject XML and what is the tag. Now if a professor thinks, yeah, it is a good question, I should answer this question, then he will click on this tick button and a window will pop up with his face and XML and what is the tag.
Now this was a text doubt. Now we can also send an audio request also here. If I want to ask something.
Take some volunteer.
So I have to first enter the topic on which I have to ask. If the teacher thinks that the topic is relevant to the subject and he should answer it, then only he will tick it. Else he can cancel.
I have received the audio doubt from Prakar and the doubt subject XML. Yeah, there will be a queue. There will be a list of doubts here. And if the professor will tick on, when he will click on the tick button of the server,
then the start button starts speaking appears here.
First of all, it was your question is one. Now it will have a button with the start speaking.
Good morning all. So I can say anything. So I have a doubt. What is the tag in XML?
Now he will disconnect, and the entry will be removed from the audio panel.
Now Mohit will tell you about iForum. What is Forum?
So sir, in the conclusion, I can only say that if this app is implemented in the practical level, then this app will prove worthy of its name. I mean the iClass, I means for, I mean technological name iClass, so it will eradicate all the sir, the main challenge was the echo cancellation, sir. We spent a lot of time searching in the net about this, the libraries and all for echo cancellation.
Why are you trying about that echo cancellation? There are a lot of other things you should do.
We use a C library known as Speaks. So it provides various features. One of the features was echo cancellation. It is a C library, so we have to use JNI, Java Native Interface, to use it with Java. Finally, we were able to implement it.
But it didn't cancel the echo.
It did cancel
to great extent, sir. I'm about 80%. So that was a delay, I think.
There's a delay, not echo.
Okay.
To a minimal level, we have tried to reduce.
Okay, already.
Thank you all.